In August of 2020, a research division of the US Department of Defense, called Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, conducted an exercise mission with several dozen military drones and ground vehicles. They were autonomous robots, designed to find targets and places of interest by themselves in order to support ground troops. The exercise was an experiment on how artificial intelligence could enhance military capability in scenarios that are too complex and dynamic for humans to make every critical decision. The AI vehicles in the experiment were not armed, but the technology is already here. Unmanned drones, capable of killing, have been around for decades, and it seems humanity is close to combining the two technologies now. Most major technology companies are currently developing some kind of autonomous vehicle. The most prominent example for the civilian sector are self-driving cars. And it is no secret that, for example, Google, Amazon, and Microsoft are working closely with the US military on several projects. Google helped develop image recognition for drone footage, Amazon also worked on facial recognition, and Microsoft will produce augmented reality headsets for the US Army. Even after years of development, with enormous amounts of learning resources, autonomous cars are still far from flawless. Tesla's autopilot could be tricked by quickly flashing an image onto the road or a wall into braking or swerving. Another successful attack involved stickers with certain pixel patterns on the side of the road, which led to the cars misidentifying objects and street signs. These errors are obviously bad enough in a traffic context and could lead to serious accidents, but similar mistakes on military equipment could be disastrous. Yet the current path is clearly leading in that direction. General John Murray of the US Army Futures Command was wondering in January 2021 in front of a virtual audience at the Center for Strategic and International Studies if it even is necessary to have a human in the loop. Meanwhile, key ethical questions for self-driving technology, like the trolley problem, still don't have agreed upon answers. Do autonomous cars optimize for overall human welfare, or should they prioritize passengers in an impending crash? If collision is unavoidable, is it more ethical to steer towards one child or two seniors? Who gets to answer these questions? Lawmakers, manufacturers, or even consumers? The European Commission has proposed strict rules for artificial intelligence in April 2021. The draft doesn't treat all uses of AI as equal. The higher the risk, meaning higher threat towards people's safety or fundamental rights, the stricter the rules. Low-risk applications would be, for example, video games or spam filters. High-risk uses would be, among others, self-driving cars, credit scoring, or job applications. Companies providing AI in high-risk categories would have to provide proof of safety as well as a risk assessment and documentation. And other governments are also tightening the rules on technology. The administrations of the United States, Great Britain, India, and China all have implemented or announced tougher oversight. It seems many states have recognized the dangers of unregulated AI, but there remains at least one problem. Most of the policy applies to companies. Even the EU's ambitious proposal, which outright bans some uses like live facial recognition in public spaces, contains exemptions for national security and the military. This would mean high-risk technology could still be developed and come into use under some circumstances. Max Tegmark, a professor at MIT, claims technology like AI weapons should be stigmatized and banned like biological weapons. A global ban on AI weapons currently seems unlikely, but the EU legislation process takes up to 2 years, a timeframe that might be used to rethink some key issues.